Lynda Cromar back again, and I want to share with you the land of my young dreams. I'm actually in kind of a crazy place. Over there, you can kind of see it, is Boulder Turnpike. And over there is I-25. I'm actually in an area that we used to call North Denver. I don't know whether it has another name or not. We're not quite to Thornton, and we're too far east of Westminster, and we're a little bit south of North Glen. Just kind of a little piece. And I'm in a business park that actually used to be a little truck farm owned by Joe Gazzetta, who was the landlord. He owned two houses, he had a whole, this entire area here was all farmed at one time. And that's where I spent the 4 years of my high school. I graduated from Mapleton High School. I don't know whether I'll get a chance to get up there to where that is, just a little bit south of here. And actually, probably can't see it from the camera lens, but the downtown area is right over there, just a few miles that direction, south. And one of the things I want to share with you is that when we are, at the beginning of the opportunities that we might have, we dream big dreams. We believe big things. We believe that we're going to accomplish a lot. And that was also the case with me. Now, I came from very, very poor beginnings, did not have much income. In fact, one of the things my mom pointed out to me one day, and I remembered, was that I had been working since actually before my 16th birthday. And I would bring home part of what I earned. And I thought it was pretty cool if I could go to the dime store or one of those really cheap little department stores I used to have and buy Japanese knockoffs of the kind of clothes that were available then, you know, the mini skirts and the cute tops. Didn't have a lot of money, but if I could buy an outfit for $2 to $4, I was in seventh heaven. Things have changed a lot since then, haven't they? And, you know, you can't see any evidence of what this place was like when I was growing up. I could point out that probably right up there in that corner there, and part of this building, was the judge's property, and she had a horse. And then the farm started right behind that. But does that matter? No. And you probably would be wondering why I'm even sharing this. And the major thing is I'm sharing it because I want you to understand that your dreams don't have to die just because you got a little older and just because some of the things you tried didn't work. I wouldn't have dreamed, even as the teenager that I was when I lived in this area, that I would have the opportunity to make money online. I mean, that was not even thought of back then because the internet wasn't even available to the individual like myself back then. Certainly we didn't have the cell phones and all of the things we have today that makes it so easy to build our business. We don't have the portable cameras like I'm using right now to build this, do this video, and, you know, at an affordable price that anybody can do. That was just not something we even thought about. I went to beauty school, I got my license, and I worked, and I got married. And the thought of being an entrepreneur was simply not in my thought process back then. And I went through a lot of things before I came to realize that there are a lot of things we need to do with our life. One of them is, see, we want to be able to help other people. Now, if you think about it, if you stay poor, like the teenage girl I'm talking about that lived in this area, you never have a chance to help other people because you're too busy trying to help yourself. Dreams do not have to die. Only, possibly, the method that might be used to create that dream. And that's what I'd like to share with you today. This is Denver Tour number 5. Lynda Cromar signing off. And I hope that you always keep your dreams alive. Bye for now.